Here we are again, twice in 1 week. Crazy, right? So here's what we got going on. I still need Micah to finish the test and also the e-learners to finish the test if you haven't already done that. So for those people, the e-learners and Micah, if you could go on Teams and complete the Chapter 9 test. Now, we are going to move on to Chapter 10. We're not going to do that today. I found it far more conducive to do this in an actual class. Meaning that the manipulation of the compass and the straight edge, we need to be face-to-face when we do this one. So we're not going to do this one online for the majority of the class here. For e-learners, just note, if there is a challenging chapter to teach over video, it's constructions. So just be ready for that. I'll probably point you to some videos during class if you're confused. If you'd like to read ahead, you can do that as well, too, and try to get a feel for what you're going to be doing in these constructions. Nothing's that challenging. But like I said, since it's a physical using your hands and whatnot, more so than your brain in order to do these things, sometimes it can be challenging to teach this over a video medium that we're doing right here. All right, so long story short, what are we doing today? We're going to review two of the things that are really important in geometry. We need to keep fresh in our mind at all times because we use them all the time, even in the last chapter. And those are the triangle similarities and triangle congruency. So just briefly and quickly, most of you guys have this pretty closely in your head. You have it memorized. But remember, it's always in your book of truth as well, too. So if we talk about triangle congruency, two triangles that are congruent, there's five ways of proving that triangle is congruent. That's SSS, SAS, ASA, AAS, and then lastly, just for right triangles, hypotenuse leg. All right. And so for each one of those letters right there, side, angle, side, that means that the side of one triangle is congruent to the other side, an angle of one triangle congruent to the angle of the other one, and the side of a second side is congruent to another side of another triangle. And just be careful with SAS, ASA, and AAS. That order is critical. Nobody messes up SSS. Nobody messes up hypotenuse leg. But those middle three, SAS, AAS, and ASA, are the ones. For SAS, it's two sides and the included angle. So two sides and the angle between them must be congruent. For AAS, it's two consecutive sides, or two consecutive angles, and then the very next side. That's why it says angle, angle, side. And lastly, for ASA, it's two angles and the included side. So the side and then this angle and this angle right here. So there's your one angle, and there's your other angle right there. Hard to do with your fingers. Okay, and so that takes care of a quick review for congruence. For similarity, there's three of them, harder ones to remember. Well, the one that we typically always use for triangle similarity is the angle angle. Show that two angles of one triangle congruent to two angles of another one, and the two triangles are similar. And we generally use that one. It's most of the time the easiest one to prove. There's only two angles we have to show, and I guess that's why it's used more often, more frequently. But there are two other ones, and that is SSS. You have to show that all three sides are in the same proportion. A lot harder to do. And then the last one is SAS. So that's two sides and the included angle, but the two sides, these two sides right here, have to be in proportion to two sides of another triangle, and the included angle in between the two sides has to be congruent. So that one's a bit more complicated. I'll open up my book here. Page 263 are the SAS and the SSS, and that kind of shows you what you have to do. Boy, SSS very rarely used because it requires the most work. SAS occasionally used, but primarily it's angle-angle. All right, so I'm going to give you a worksheet. I'll be online the entire day, so if you run into any issues, you can send me a quick email or a chat on Teams. I'll be more than happy to help you out, or we'll go online, Zoom meeting or something like that. So not too many. I'll probably give you about 16. I haven't made the worksheet yet, but I'll give you about 16 or so to do. You should tear through them. I'll give you eight of each. Tear through that, and that's just to keep this stuff fresh in our mind. So as we go through the rest of the chapter, that we don't have to review this again. All right. So you guys have a nice, warm, and cozy snow day. Eat a cookie for me. And remember, don't forget your compass and your protractor for tomorrow when we start constructions. For the entire chapter, you will need your compass and your protractor every single day. Okay? Have a great day.